As health authorities race to stop the spread of the virus, the city's list of exposure sites grows. These pictures are from a Potts Point cafe deep cleaning there late last night. New South Wales Health has added new venues of concern in Double Bay, Bondi and Bondi Junction. And it doesn't stop there. Exposure sites now sprawl into Sydney's southwest. Here's Hayley Francis at Casula.
Well, this homemaker centre in Casula in Sydney's southwest is among the fast-growing list of new venues added to the exposure sites overnight. A person with COVID-19 having visited multiple shops here on Sunday. The time of concern is between 1:30 and 2:30 p.m. They went to Freedom, Fantastic, Amart and Supreme Furniture. Now, anyone who visited these places at that time is now considered a close contact and must now get tested immediately and self-isolate for 14 days, regardless of that test result. Now, this is all too familiar territory for locals here who, of course, were caught up in the Crossroads Hotel cluster around a year ago. That was linked to nearly 60 cases of COVID-19.
The numbers were going down and now it's going back up, and then it just starts all over again. And we just like started to get our freedom back, really.
We had our freedom at one stage, we were happy, and now it's happening all over again. You know, it's just a bit of a downfall pretty much, so we're not happy about it really.
Gregory Hills has also emerged as an area on watch. The town centre, which includes a Woolworths and a bakery, visited by a COVID-positive shopper on Sunday afternoon. Other locations include Bankstown Amart Furniture, Domino's Pizza at Merrylands, as well as a burger shop, the Big Bun, and Kmart at Parramatta on Wednesday morning. Now, obviously, we're seeing more and more of these venues pop up on the New South Wales Health website as contact tracers work overtime to try and get ahead of any potential further spread of this. The message remains and is clear. If you have the mildest of symptoms, you should get tested and stay up with the latest details on the New South Wales Health website.